Well, initially everything looked really good, and ecologically speaking, it's still looking really good. You know, we're not seeing any negative impacts of rats at this time. You know, the vegetation is doing really well. The native plants are able to set fruit, and the native birds are successfully breeding right now. And we haven't seen any signs of any rat predation thus far. So that's been really positive. But we have a really extensive monitoring program across the whole island, and we have had pictures of rats on camera. So we know they're around in very low numbers, and we're doing our best to address it while they're still in a low density and in a way that, you know, hopefully can wrap it up. Yeah, so we've got some dogs here, and they are going to be surveying the island in areas where we've seen localized rat presence. So we haven't seen rats everywhere on the island. They've just been in little pockets. And so we're going to be surveying with the dogs in those areas and trying to assess how widespread the rat presence is, and hopefully control some of them with the dogs. Yes, definitely. You know, the heat is brutal out here. The sun is very intense, and the black rock, you know, emanates heat. So it's definitely difficult conditions. There's no trees, no shade, and there's a lot of birds, so a lot of distractions. But these dogs are trained to deal with that, and they will hopefully do what we need them to. Search out rats and either locate them so that we can target those areas with other control measures, or directly remove the rats by, you know, grabbing them, digging them out, that kind of thing. You know, we did monitor the presence of bait across the island in various plots during the applications, and there was good coverage of bait across the island. So bait was available to the rats that were up there, and for some reason or another, they didn't take it. I don't have direct experience, but dogs are a really popular and effective tool in a lot of conservation projects for a variety of different means. So hopefully it will be just as effective out here.
Terriers in general, it's in their genetic makeup to hunt rodents. That's what they were bred for from hundreds of years ago. Border terriers in particular are very like biddable, more so than say like a Jack Russell Terrier. So we think that makes them a good breed to do this kind of work. Charlotte has been breeding these dogs for over 20 years, so she's very experienced with terriers and has hunted rats with them and participate in AKC, earth dog and barn hunt type of rodent hunting events. But as far as like a field, you know, environment with seabirds, that's definitely new to us and challenge. Well, I think one of the most important things is kind of what we're doing now, exposing them to the birds and desensitizing them, getting them to ignore the birds so that we can more easily differentiate between their behavior when they find a rodent versus if they just notice a bird. We already know their behavior when they find rodents, but it's such a distracting environment that they're not used to. We, the handlers, might not be able to read it very well. So that's probably the most important thing. We're pretty confident in their ability to find rodents aside from the distractions.
Thank you. Sure.
Yeah.
Henry. Go ahead.
No, you're fine. Okay. Right alongside you here. Yeah. Be hard work for you little guys, huh? Stereo panting. Yep. This could be in a choir. Thanks, David. Bye.
So the dog's been... Oh, yeah.
Pulled the bandage last Wednesday. Oh. The chair.
She wants to... Can we do like a semicircle around that on the upwind side or downwind? Something in there?
I don't know.
The wind's coming from this way, but can we have you check?
What is,
no, he's not really showing any. Okay.
And is that
Was it over here?
There's a bird in there.
Is it connected possibly underground? And that's a shearwater right there? So if there's a bird and a rat, then we can't really approach it anyway, right?
I'm just gonna go look at that.